Blue Origin is often written off as just a copy of SpaceX, who doesn't accomplish nearly as much. Aside from this, the negative image that is often associated with Jeff Bezos doesn't help the company's case very much. NASA selected SpaceX to develop a human landing system to land astronauts on the moon by 2024, under the Artemis program. The agency faced a lot of opposition from competitors Blue Origin and Dynetics, that also bid to develop a HLS. The companies filed protests against NASA claiming its selection process was unfair. Despite of the opposition, NASA is moving forward to award SpaceX a $2.89 billion HLS contract to develop a lunar-optimized Starship. On July 30, the U.S. Government Accountability Office rejected the HLS contract protests that were filed by Blue Origin and Dynetics. Yao said in a written announcement, NASA did not violate procurement law or regulation when it decided to make only one award. NASA's announcement provided that the number of awards the agency would make was subject to the amount of funding available for the program, they wrote. In addition, the announcement reserved the right to make multiple awards, a single award, or no award at all. In reaching its award decision, NASA concluded that it only had sufficient funding for one contract award. Yao further concluded there was no requirement for NASA to engage in discussions, amend, or cancel the announcement, as a result of the amount of funding available for the program. NASA did not act improperly in making a single award to SpaceX. Soon after Yao's announcement, the agency paid $300 million to SpaceX, which is a portion of the HLS award to develop a Starship lunar lander. This information is revealed in the federal website, where the U.S. government publishes spending data. It states that the funds are for work required for the design, development, manufacture, test, launch, demonstration, and engineering support of the Human Landing System, HLS, integrated lander. In response to NASA paying a major portion of the HLS award, a Twitter user asked SpaceX founder Elon Musk if he expects to have Lunar Starship ready to land humans in 2024, despite other delays, to which Musk replied, probably sooner. SpaceX President Gwynne Shotwell said in 2019 that the company aims to land an uncrewed Starship on the lunar surface by 2022. In the last 2 years, the company has made significant progress with the launch system's development and it is ready to begin pre-flight preparations to launch their first Starship launch vehicle to orbit this year. The flight test will provide engineers valuable insight towards the spacecraft's development. At the Starbase facility in South Texas, SpaceX has a NASA lunar lander mock-up nose cone on display. It gives onlookers a glimpse of the future from the public road. Blue Origin and SpaceX, the documentation argued, had materially different operational concepts to land humans on the moon. That precluded SpaceX from receiving an advantage due to the FRR modifications, the GAO argued. Blue Origin aimed to meet HLS landing requirements with a single launch, whereas SpaceX was planning multiple launches of Starship in support of a landing, the GAO stated. As for Dynetics, its chief concern was alleging favorable treatment of SpaceX for the FRR requirement, something Blue Origin also alleged, but the GAO said it does not find that the protesters' arguments demonstrate a reasonable possibility of competitive prejudice under the circumstances here. In a footnote, the office added that it did consider other protests from Dynetics and Blue Origin, not all of which are covered in the document. But one of the principal points brought up at the time concerned the amount of funding that NASA received for HLS. For example, Blue Origin founder Jeff Bezos publicly alleged that only SpaceX was invited to send a revised budget to reflect the amount of HLS money NASA received from Congress. Bezos, a billionaire, also offered to cover the congressional shortfall. The GAO said the protests have failed for several reasons, mainly that the procurement was done under a federal acquisition regulation that allows for the agency to consider fund availability in its decision. In any event, the protesters' arguments are without any factual support, the GAO continued, saying SpaceX outperformed the competition in the three chief metrics for HLS, technical approach, price and management. Even assuming a comparative analysis was required, SpaceX's proposal appeared to be the highest rated, under each of the three enumerated evaluation criteria, the GAO stated. First reported by The Verge, Blue Origin filed its lawsuit against NASA, with the U.S. Court of Federal Claims on Monday, August 16, and continues to spout the same kind of rhetoric that GAO wholeheartedly refuted on July 30. Namely, the office explicitly upheld the procurement process and reasoning behind NASA's decision to award SpaceX, and SpaceX alone, a contract to develop a crewed moon lander. Thus far, the central argument put forth by Blue Origin and Dynetics is that NASA effectively invalidated the entire human landing system option of procurement when it didn't award two HLS development contracts. Option A refers to a limited portion of the HLS program focused on funding the development of crewed moon landers and the completion of two crucial flight tests, one uncrewed and one with NASA astronauts aboard. For Blue Origin's lawsuit to succeed, the increasingly desperate company will have to convince a federal judge that basic realities and long-standing precedents of federal procurement, not just NASA's HLS award to SpaceX, are flawed and need to be changed. The odds of success are thus spectacularly low. However, if the presiding judge allows the case to proceed and awards Blue Origin an injunction against NASA, it could force the space agency to cease work on SpaceX's HLS contract for months, and potentially, freeze SpaceX's access to the $300 million NASA recently disbursed. SpaceX's upcoming orbital Starship flight test will enable the company to collect valuable data of the vehicle in flight, as well as demonstrate that its Starlink broadband constellation can beam internet communication to the spacecraft in motion. Their current flight plan is to launch Super Heavy from Starbase South Texas and land it on water in the Gulf of Mexico, soon after dropping off Starship SN20 to orbit. The spacecraft will continue flying in orbit above the Florida Straits, then re-enter Earth's atmosphere to splashdown off the northwest coast of Hawaii, near a military base. With approximately 1,740 Starlink satellites orbiting Earth, SpaceX plans to demonstrate how the broadband network can provide data to Starship, even during the parts of the launch where communication signals are lost due to the presence of ionized plasma in the atmosphere as spacecraft re-enters. According to a recent filing with the Federal Communications Commission, SpaceX seeks authorization to test its Starlink internet network during the debut orbital flight. SpaceX's Starship spacecraft and Super Heavy booster represent a fully reusable transportation system, designed to carry both crew and cargo to Earth orbit, the Moon, Mars and beyond. The company's Special Temporary Authority application says, SpaceX intends to mount Starlink satellite terminals on the Super Heavy booster and orbital Starship for Starship's first orbital test flight and use these terminals to communicate with SpaceX's Starlink satellite constellation.
President Gwynne Shotwell say that much money could single-handedly
On the ground at the launch site in Starbase, Texas during launch, during booster recovery, in flight, and during re-entry, the company stated. Starlink can provide unprecedented volumes of telemetry and enable communications during atmospheric re-entry. When ionized plasma around the spacecraft inhibits conventional telemetry frequencies, these tests will demonstrate Starlink's ability to improve the efficiency and safety of future orbital spaceflight missions, SpaceX said. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.